Print email, Facebook, Twitter. More. Guatemala volcano: rescuers suspend search amid dangerous conditions as death toll hits 100. Media player: space to play, M to mute, left and right to seek. :00:00:3600:00:36 Rescuers have suspended search and recovery efforts at villages devastated by the eruption of Guatemala's volcano of fire, prompting people with missing loved ones to do the risky work themselves with rudimentary tools. The death toll from a series of eruptions that began on Sunday has been gradually rising and now stands at 100, police said. COMRED, the National Disaster Agency, said climatic conditions and still hot volcanic material was making it dangerous for rescuers, and it was also taking into account that 72 hours had passed since Sunday's eruption. That is the window beyond which officials had said it would be extremely unlikely to find any survivors amid the ash, mud and other debris that buried homes up to their rooftops. It rained very hard yesterday. The soil is unstable, said Pablo Castillo. A spokesman for National Police, Oscar Chavez, trekked over a mountain with his father and younger brother to search for his brother Edgar, sister-in-law Sandra and nephew Josue in the hamlet of San Miguel Los Lotes, which was almost entirely wiped out by the volcanic flows. They have not been heard from since the eruption. We looked for them in shelters, hospitals, everywhere, but we did not find them, said Mr. Chavez, 34. As the others used sticks and a machete to try to tear down a wall and the metal corrugated roof of a home. So, better for us to come here. About 10 police officers saw what the family was doing and came to help, bringing more robust tools. At a shelter set up in a school in the nearby city of Escuintla, workers fastened colorful ID bracelets on the wrists of people who are among several thousand displaced by the eruption. Rescue teams have been searching frantically for survivors and victims in the lava-ravaged landscape. The violent eruptions showered volcanic ash over nearby towns and spewed pyroclastic flows throughout the area. U.S. dispatches, aid, aircrafts and financial resources. The United States announced it was sending emergency aid, including financial resources, to help meet food, water and sanitation needs. Washington also dispatched aircraft to help transport burn victims to Florida and Texas. A U.S. Air Force C-17 carried 6 badly burned Guatemalan children for treatment at the Shriners Hospital in Galveston, Texas late on Wednesday, local time. White House spokeswoman Sarah Huckabee Sanders offered deepest condolences to victims and said the aid was being provided at the request of the government of Guatemala, International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, IFRC, raised concerns about the economic cost of the disaster in the poor Central American country. We should not underestimate the scale of this disaster, IFRC President Francesco Rocco said in a statement on Thursday. Critical. Emergency needs are still enormous, and affected communities will need sustained and long-term support. Mr. Rocca noted that ash had fallen across more than half of Guatemala, covering areas where agriculture is crucial. We hope it will not mean a secondary disaster, he said. The IFRC has pledged more than 250,000 Swiss francs, $334,510, to support rescue efforts, and said those worst hit would need at least a year to recover. Wednesday, a downpour forced rescue teams to retreat for fear of mudslides and boiling water flowing down the volcano's slopes from dangerously hot volcanic gas and ash. A day earlier, flows of superheated volcanic material forced crews to pull back. The suspension of rescue efforts around the volcano may be lifted if conditions on the ground improve, Korn said. AP/Reuters print email, Facebook, Twitter.